In this video, we will talk about some of the vector algebra operations that we can perform. So, vector algebra. So if I have two vectors, let's say a equal to a sub x I hat plus a sub y j hat, another vector b as b sub x I hat plus b sub y j hat, and I want to add these two vectors. So I already have their Cartesian representation. I want to add them together. All I have to do is make sure that I'm adding apples to apples and oranges to oranges. So the apples over here are the x components and the oranges are y components. You add x component, y component, y component. So this would be ax plus bx I hat plus ay plus by j hat. That's how you would add them. If you want to subtract them, you do a minus b, and this would be a sub x minus b sub x I hat plus a sub y minus b sub y j hat. Okay, so adding and subtraction of the vectors is not a problem. You can also multiply a vector with a scalar. So let's say I wanted to multiply a with lambda. Lambda could be a number, let's say 2 or 3. Then this would be simply lambda times a sub x I hat plus a sub y times j hat. And the graphically speaking, you could probably see easily that this has the effect of either lengthening or contracting or shortening a vector. So if lambda was, you know, 2, and let's say this is my vector a over here, and I multiply this with a factor of 2, then essentially the length of the vector a would be twice of what it was in the same direction. If the lambda was 0, this would become basically a 0 vector. If lambda was minus 1, you would flip it. So essentially it will become, you know, minus vector a. Okay, so addition of the vectors, subtraction of the vectors, multiplying a vector with a scalar is not a problem. What about multiplying the two vectors? So if I have vector A and I want to multiply it with vector B. It's very likely that in your high school classes you have learned that you really cannot multiply the two vectors except to do what we call a specialized product operation, things like dot products. And cross product. So what's a dot product? Dot product is given as A dot B and is defined as magnitude of A times magnitude of B times cosine of the angle between the two vectors. So if I have a vector A here, let's say this is 5 meters per second, and then I have another vector over here which is 2 meters per second, okay, and this is an x and y frame, and I know the angle between the two is, let's say, 45 degree, and I want to do a dot product between the two vectors. How do we find that? Well, magnitude of A is 5, and magnitude of B is 2, cosine of the angle is cosine 45, which is 1 over root 2, so that will be 10 over root 2, okay? So that's the dot product between the two vectors. So you can see that the resultant quantity is actually a scalar quantity because you only get a number out of it, right? Now, what's a sort of a graphical meaning or a, you know, I should say, you know, geometric intuition behind what dot product is? So it's actually a projection. So let's say we have vector A over here. This is vector A, and here is my vector B, okay? And I want to do a dot product between the two. So A dot B is equal to magnitude of A times magnitude of B times cosine theta. Now, magnitude of B times cosine theta is basically if you draw a perpendicular from the tip of vector B to vector A, then magnitude of B cosine theta is basically this length. This is the angle theta, this is this length, right? So essentially, magnitude of B cosine theta is a projection on vector A. And now you're multiplying that projection with the magnitude of vector A itself. And that's what you're getting when you do the dot product. Cross product, A cross B, on the other hand, is slightly different. This is defined as magnitude of A times magnitude of B times sine of the angle between the two times a unit vector perpendicular to both vector A and B. So what will be a vector perpendicular to both vector A and B? Well, you define the plane formed by vector A and vector B, and perpendicular to that plane, you can define a unit vector, and that's what you would have over here. So you can clearly see that vector, that A cross B is actually a vector quantity because of the presence of this over here. This will be the magnitude part, but n hat over here will give the direction of this cross product too. Okay, so how do we find what this n hat would be? All right, for that I'm going to write a and b in their full form using Cartesian representation. So vector a is, let's say, a1 I hat plus a2 j hat plus a3 k hat. So here I have actually a three-dimensional vector. So I have x-axis, I have y-axis, and then I have z-axis. Unit vector along x is I hat, unit vector along y is j hat, unit vector along z is k hat, okay? So vector A is, you know, let me draw this in a different color. So here is my vector A. So what is A1, A2, A3 over here? If I draw projection on, let's say, the x and y-axis or x and z-axis over here, okay? That's the projection, and then I draw a line from the origin to this. So we have this XZ plane. So in this case, this would be A1, this would be A3, and this length from here to here would be A2, okay? So that's what A1, A2, A3 are in this case. So remember, this is a 90 degree projection, okay? In the XZ plane, all right? Okay, so that's vector A. And then I have my vector B defined as B1 I hat plus B2 J hat plus B3 K hat. And I want to do a cross product between the two. So how do I do that? So A cross B would be equal to A1 I hat plus A2 J hat plus A3 K hat cross B1 I hat plus B2 J hat plus B3 K hat. Okay, now the cross product will distribute through this. So this will be actually A1 times B1 I cross I. Now what's I cross I? I cross I, by definition of the cross product, would be magnitude of I times magnitude of I times sine of the angle between the two. So let's do it for I cross I. So I cross I, which are also vectors, they're just unit vectors, would be magnitude of I times magnitude of I times sine of the angle between the two. But what's this, the angle between I hat and I hat? They're same vector, so that'll be zero, okay? So, and then of course you will have a unit vector perpendicular to both of them, but it won't matter because sine zero is actually zero. So this is actually a zero vector, okay? So A1, B1 times I cross I will be multiplied with zero. So you can see that this would be the case for J cross J as well as for K cross K. So all the like vectors, when we take their cross product, the result would be actually zero. The next term would be plus A1 B2 I cross J, right? So I cross J. Now let's find out what I cross J is. So I cross J is equal to magnitude of I times magnitude of J, which are both actually one, because by definition I hat and J hat are unit vectors. So this is one, this is one, sine of the angle between I and J. Now the angle between I and J is actually 90 degree because these are Cartesian axes. These axes are perpendicular to each other. So angle between I and J is 90, angle between I and K is 90, angle between J and K is 90. So this is actually sine 90, right? Now, then we also have this n hat, which indicates the direction. So what is that direction that we have for I cross J? So to find that, basically what we do is we wrap our fingers going from I hat to J hat, and see which way our thumb points. And we're doing this with our right hand. Okay, so we are using a right-handed rule. So we curl our fingers going from I to J and then see which way our thumb is pointing. So if you curl your finger, this is, you know, your hand, right? And then you go from I to J, you curl it this way, and your thumb would be pointing towards K hat. So this would be actually K hat. So the answer is I cross J is equal to K hat. Okay, that's the one way to do it. The other way is that you can imagine that you have a screwdriver in your hand, and the screwdriver is actually pointing in a direction perpendicular to the plane defined by I and J, and you rotate your screwdriver going from I to J, okay? If you do that, imagine if you had a screw at the tip of your screwdriver, which way the screw would move. So if you put your screwdriver right here, so let me draw this separately to show you. So this is I, this is, you know, J over here, okay? And I put a screwdriver right over here, and I'm going to rotate the screwdriver in this direction, which will be counterclockwise because I have to go from I to J. So the only rotation we have is the counterclockwise rotation. If I rotate my screwdriver in the counterclockwise direction, a screw, if it is placed at the tip of the screwdriver, is going to come towards you, perpendicular to the plane towards you, right? That means it's basically you're unscrewing it as a result. So that's the direction which is k hat. Okay, so this is equal to k hat. On the other hand, if you do j cross i, it will be magnitude of j times magnitude of I, which are of course both 1 because of the definition, and then sine 90, that's sine 90 is 1 also, so this is 1, times unit vector going from j to I. So now you'll be rotating your screwdriver in the clockwise direction, and the screw would be going inward. That's actually negative k hat direction, so this would be minus k hat. So the answer would be minus k hat, right? So I cross j would be k, j cross would be minus k hat. Similarly, you would have j cross k equal to I hat. You'll have k cross I equal to j hat. And if you flip these, so if instead of j cross k, you do k cross j, that would be actually minus I hat. And if you do I cross k, that would be minus j hat. So all we have to do is use these identities inside this box to write the expression over here. Okay, so I cross j, and then we have a1, b3, I cross k, plus a2, b1, j cross I, and then a2, b2, j cross j would be 0, so I'll neglect that, and then a2, b3, j cross k, plus a3, b1, k cross I, plus a3, b2, k cross j, and finally plus a3, b3, k cross k, which would be 0. So we are left with basically only 6 non-zero terms over here, right? And if we collect them together, what we get is something like this. So we'll have I hat, okay? I hat would be a2 b3 minus a3 b2 plus j hat, that's actually a1 b3 minus b1 a3, and then finally the k hat terms, which will be a1 b2 minus a2 b1. This is also written in a more compact fashion like this. So we write I, j, and k is a determinant form, a1, a2, a3, b1, b2, b3. So the way we write this is that I hat is a2, b3 minus b2, a3, which is right over here. Then j hat, the coefficient of j hat is a1, b3 minus b1, a3. This would be k cross I is j, so that will be a3 b1 minus a1 b3 j plus, then I have my k hat, so that would be a1 b2 minus a2 b1, right? Okay, so this can also be written in a slightly different form using what we call determinant form. So this is a1 a2 a3 b1 b2 b3, and the way we write the cross product is that I hat coefficient would be a2 b3 minus b2 a3, and then the coefficient of j hat would be b1 a3 minus a1 b3, and then the coefficient of k hat would be a1 b2 minus b1 a2. Okay, so that's how we compute the cross product. Now you could also use the same way to compute the dot product also. Okay, so all we need is this basic definition to see what the dot product would look like. So a dot b would be equal to a1 I hat plus a2 j hat plus a3 k hat dot b1 I hat plus b2 j hat plus b3 k hat. So let's do the dot product. So a1 b1 I dot I is 1, I dot j would be 0 because I dot j is equal to magnitude of a times magnitude of b times cosine theta. The theta angle between I and j is 90, so cosine 90 is 0, so it'll be 0. So we won't have that. Similarly, I dot k would be 0. Then we'll have a2 b2, j dot j is 1, plus a3 b3, because k dot k is 1. So that's a dot b. So if you know Cartesian representation of the two vectors and you have to compute their dot product, it's an easy thing to do by simply multiplying the corresponding components and then adding them together.